Good morning, class. So today we are going to start with a new topic, that is even numbers and odd numbers. Yes, today we will read about even numbers and odd numbers. You can see here I have already written the topic. First we will read about even numbers. Okay, so the first question arises, what is even numbers? Yes, we will read about that. I have already written numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 at the ones place. Again I am reading numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 at the ones place are called even numbers. Okay, before going to the definition, you can see here I have written ones place. Yes, here I have written ones place. So you remember what is ones place? For a short example I am giving, here I have written the number 42. Okay? So as we already know, the last number will be said as the ones place. Okay? Whether it is a 2-digit number or a 3-digit number, we will always say the last place as a ones place. Okay? In this place, if you see these numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, then this whole number will be said as a even number. Again, I am repeating, if a number is having 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 at ones place means the last place, okay, then the whole number will be said as a even number. So you have to remember these 5 numbers 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. These 5 numbers you have to remember, these are will be your even numbers. Here are some examples I have written. First is 20. What? 20. 2, 0. So the ones place is this one. So in ones place you can see 0 is there. So when in ones place 0 is present, the whole number will be said as a even number. So the next example, 42, I have already explained. Here comes 314. Yes? So in ones place you can see 4 is there. 4. So this whole number will be said as a even number. Now the next example is 56. In ones place we are having 6. So you can see here 6. So the whole number will be said as a even number. Next example, 998. You can see in ones place we are having 8. This 8. So this whole number will be said as a even number. Okay. So again I am saying such a small example, how to remember these 5 numbers. You have already read the multiplication table of 2. Yes, multiplication table of 2 you have to remember. Okay. So here you can see 0, 2 into 1, 2, 2 into 2, 4, 2 into 3, 6, 2 into 4, 8. So these are the multiples of 2. You can see. So you have to remember this 5 numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So whenever you see these numbers in ones place, you will say the whole number to be a even number. Okay? Understood all of you? So our next topic is odd numbers. Here I have written odd numbers. Let's go first what is odd numbers. Okay? Numbers having 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 at the ones place. Again I am reading numbers having 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 at the ones place are called odd numbers. Here also 5 numbers are there which we have to learn. If we see 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 in any of the ones place of the number, then that whole number will be said as a odd number. Ones place, again I am repeating, the last part of the number, the last number will be said as a ones place. So in ones place, if you see 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, any of these numbers present, then the whole number will be said as a odd number. So see, all of you, I have written some examples here. 11. So in ones place we are having 1. This 1. So it is a odd number. 29. In ones place we are having 9. This one 9. So it is a odd number. 55. In ones place we are having 5. 5. So it is an odd number. 793. Here, 1 plus 3. So it is an odd number. 647. In 1's place we are having 7. So it is an odd number. Understood all of you? Again I am repeating. So when you see 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, these numbers in the 1's place, then the whole number will be said as an odd number. Okay, children? So now we are going to do some examples and we will write down whether the number is even or odd. Look at the examples. First is 42. Okay? So here you can see in ones place, 2 is here. So it will come in even. So it is an even number. Here I have written which one will be the even and which one you will be the odd. So from here you can see and write down. 39. So here you can see 9 in the ones place. So 9 in the ones place means it is an odd number. Here you can see 3, 43, 3 in the ones place. And 3 will be said as an odd number. 58. In ones place you can see 8 is there. So when we see 8 in ones place, so it will be an even number. 66. 6 in the ones place. So you can see if we have 6 in the ones place, it will be said as an even number. So it will be even number. 141. 141. So in ones place you can see 1 is here. So you can see here if ones place is having 1, it is an odd number. So you will write down odd number. 787. So in ones place we are having 7. So you can see here in ones place if we have 7, then it will be said as an odd number. So you can write down odd. Our last example, this is 600. In ones place we are having 0. Okay? So when ones place is having 0, it will be said as an even number. So you will write down even number. So from here, another thing we are concluding that after every even number, there is an odd number. And after every odd number, there is an even number. Let me see how. So you will write down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So 1 is an odd number. And after odd number, there is an even number. So 2 is an even number. Then after 2, 3. And 3 is an odd number. After 3, 4. 4 is an even number. After 4, 5. 5 is an odd number. So here you can see that after every odd number, there is an even number. And after every even number, there is an odd number. So this process continues till the end of the numbers. Again, I am repeating both of the even and odd numbers. So numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 at the ones place will be said as an even number. And the numbers having 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 at the ones place will be said as an odd numbers. I hope you all have understood the even and odd numbers. Do the exercise from the book and get ready for the revision classes. यू।